system, which means that we have a variety of fiscal and non-fiscal benefits. The most sort of the top line one, I suppose, is the tax. So 5% tax the first 10 years and 10% thereafter. Corporate tax in Botswana is about 22%. So this is a huge saving.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. I'm joined by Giyani Metals CEO Charles Fitzroy. Charlie, very good to speak with you. You've announced that you've secured a special economic zone license for your plant site in Botswana. So a significant milestone for Giyani.
Yes, Stephen, really good to see you and fantastic news to be starting off 2025 with. So our commercial plant, which will be located in Botswana next to our ore sources, we have about just under 2,000 square kilometres of licences there. And our most progressed ore project is called the Cahill project. And we have now applied for and received, after a very rigorous process with the government, go through everything about Giyani from an economic, social, sustainability point of view to understand about the company. And they've deemed it that we are suitable for a special economic zone license. And that means that our plant will be sitting in this license area. The plant will be adjacent to the mine, but it'll be sitting under this special zone, which means that we have a variety of fiscal and non-fiscal benefits. The most sort of the top line one, I suppose, is the tax. So 5% tax the first 10 years and 10% thereafter. Corporate tax in Botswana is about 22%. So this is a huge saving. And again, another really important thing to point out is our 2023 PEA didn't take this into account. So these are savings which will go into our DFS, which is underway now. So this is a really fantastic thing for us as a group and also for the support it shows from the Botswana government for Giyani.
And this is a 50-year license, right?
Yes, 50 years, and then we can renew it multiple times. So it's a fantastic thing for Giyani to have received.
Of course, so Charlie, at the same time, you've got your demo plants in Johannesburg, you're nearing first production there. And of course, all the learnings you have from your Johannesburg demo plant will be applied to this plant in Botswana once you get going with it.
Yes, exactly, Stephen. So our commercial facility, which is planned for Botswana, and it now will be located in this special economic zone, is going to be basically 10 times larger of our demonstration plant, which is in Johannesburg. The demo plant is designed for many, many reasons. One is to de-risk the commercial facility. It's also to de-risk the flow sheet and to produce product for off-takers. And also all these learning, as you mentioned, to go into the commercial plant, which will enable a speedier ramp up of the commercial facility and to remove any risk which might have occurred during that ramp up. And this demonstration facility is, as we speak, commissioning, and any moment we'll be having products out of it. It's been a very very interesting last few months, and we're getting so close to it. And we are hosting actually an investor site visit on the 1st of February, just before the Indaba week. So a lot of investors will there be seeing the product, or hopefully product coming out. As we said, very close. And we're looking forward to updating the market the moment we get first products out of that plant, and which is now in the final stages of the commissioning, the C4 stage of commissioning C5.
Charlie, what else can your investors look forward to in 2025?
So 2025 is really going to be a transformative year for Giyani. The demonstration plant, as I mentioned, is imminently due to produce first product. Once we get that, we will ship that product off to off-takers who are waiting for us. We've got groups lined up from groups in North America, the EU, and Asia. And then we'll go into off-take process discussions, and we want to get that obviously sorted out as soon as possible, because our DFS is underway. Our DFS is due this year. Once that DFS is finished, then we can finalize any project financing, and we get that secured as soon as possible. And then going into next year, getting project financing finished and into the project construction. So this year is a formative year for the group. And we've recently actually added a very key hire. We've added our head of corporate development, Sean Taser, who joined us from the Palinghurst group to help with offtake and project financing. Sean comes from that group. He's got a huge amount of experience in critical minerals and especially offtake. So we're strengthening the team and moving into this year with a very strong start. Special economic zone, as I just mentioned, is a fantastic step forward for the group, and a big thanks and obviously awards to the team. And also got to thank the Botswana government for working with us and really supporting the company.
Well, I hope you'll keep us posted on any progress. Thank you very much for the update today.
Thanks, Stephen.
That's Giyani Metals CEO Charles Fitzroy.